Hello, everyone, and welcome on in to Central of Concave Souls Tarot. This is Sunny. I am very, very blessed and highly favored enough to be able to be on with you amazing, wonderful people here today. I am here to do a reading for Leo. It's time for the Leo reading. I was going to get on a little bit earlier, but got kind of pressed for time, so... But now's the perfect time. I was considering the prophetic number 202. Yeah, I just did see that number come in for you all. Please look that number for prophetic meaning 202. The Spirit gave me way to see a vision of that number concerning you all before the reading, Leo. Why don't you all take a moment to like and subscribe to the channel? I really appreciate it when you do. To my current subscribers, I thank you. If you're new here, welcome on in. Yeah, where we are journeying and sojourning the soul. Yeah, where we are obtaining truths from behind the veil. Yeah, for meaning, understanding, peace, growth, and moving forward in our lives. Yeah, also, please do leave me a comment, you all. I love it when you all comment so that I just know how to manifest in you all's lives. And if the readings are resonating with you, and just how you all are doing in general, please do leave me a comment. Also, if you're looking for a personal reading, the information is listed within the channel. Yeah. So how are you all guys doing? How are you all doing? Let me know how you all are doing, Leo. We're going to be taking a look at the center of your heart space. We're going to take a look at what's happening behind the embers of the veil. Then we'll take a review of the spirit realm. Then we will take a look at the soul realm and then move further on into your reading to see what Mr. Spirit has for you at this time. Yeah, this is. And we are going to seek truths that have not yet been witnessed. Yeah, portals. Yeah, we commune with you now, spirits. We invoke all kind kindred spirits, all angelic hosts, all heavenly divine beings at this time on the behalf of Leo. Yeah, we ask for permission for access to portals, yeah, dimensions, dominions, and principalities that have not been foreseen. Yeah, the untraceable of knowledge we seek at this time on behalf of Leo. With Leo at this time, please. Happening with Leo. Let's see. Spirits, give us the highest and divinest for the highest trope of Leo at this time, please. What is happening with my Leo? What's happening with my Leo right now? Okay, what's happening at the center of the heart space for Leo at this time, please? Happening at the center of the heart space for my Leo. Spirit's reading is for Leo at this time. We ask for the highest divine message for the highest good of Leo at this time. It's happening at the center of the heart space. Okay, thank you, spirits. Oh. My goodness, Leo, this is great. You all are in the faces of the deep phase, the premise of the veil. Yeah, yeah, you all here are meeting God in the spirit. My goodness, you all, I think this is the first time I've seen this card come out for any of you, for any of the signs. Yeah, this, yeah. And the faces, let me explain that too, the faces of the deep. Is when we meet ourselves within God prior to the creation of the world, yet before the speaking of light and darkness was infused into the energies. Yeah, that's where you are. Yeah, this card speaks directly to wisdom and conception. Yes, my goodness. The veil of concave souls, soul dualism. Yeah, the arisen souls, the fallen souls, the kept souls. My goodness. Yeah, the heart of innocence and the premise to all betrayal. Yeah. So a lot of you are really suffering here from the betrayal of self. Yeah, the great betrayal, the ultimate betrayal of you. Yeah, the counter-dualistic soulism here. Yeah, the soul dualism. Yeah, a lot of you are betwixt hating yourself and loving yourself at the same time, Leo. Yeah, a lot of deep digging going on in the soul. Yeah, so that you can arise. Yeah, I feel for a lot of you, you've been feeling fallen for quite some time. Yeah, but the divine is keeping you. Yeah, preserving your heart of innocence. Yeah, preserving the heart of God that has to be bestowed to us upon relinquishing of the earth realm heart. Yeah, the premise to all betrayal. Let's take a dig deeper here. Yeah, the ultimate betrayal of you. Let's see, what's going on with Leo at this time, please? Yeah, I'm hearing in spirit a lot of you are suffering in silence. Yeah, regarding your own self. Yeah, your own self suffering in silence. Ooh, they wanted to come out. Oh, yeah, that's what it is, Leo. A lot of you all are experiencing holding yourselves accountable. Yeah, this card speaks to on what I have deemed and therefore defined self-actualized accountability. Self-actualized accountability, Leo, is the systematic account of one's refusals of awareness realized. Yeah, look at that. Divine truths housed within the hidden soul. My goodness. It is therefore the origin of the denial of investment in self, Leo. Yeah, you're taking a soul review, of how, you're feeling very somber over the fact that there's been little to no investment in yourself. Yeah, these are things, secrets of your own soul being revealed. Yeah, the origin of the denial of investment in self. Yeah, furthermore, Leo, as I have ingested, self-actualized accountability is the definitive sphere of the heart that contains every denial, withdrawal, withholding, contradiction of internal parting, deterioration of faith, negation, and refutation. Upon further calculation, I have deemed and concluded also that SAA, which is what I have termed for philosophical understanding, self-actualized accountability, Leo, is the foundational corruptor to concave truth, within, the sphere of the soul. Therefore, the absolute false representation of the manifestation of all divine truths, concluded to be a derivative of the self and self-experience. Yeah, my goodness, Leo, this is directly where you all are. Yeah, the dualism. Yeah, counter-dualistic soulism. Yeah, the dualistic experience here that we face when we are betwixt hating ourselves and loving ourselves. Yeah, some of you are in the fight of your lives right now. We're about ready to give up. The spirit got me on here. Yeah, at 2:17 a.m., to come against that spirit of darkness. Yeah, that's coming against you, Leo. Yeah, a spirit of giving up. A spirit of hopelessness. Yeah, a feeling of not being good enough. Yeah, a feeling of not being able to produce. Yeah, and being able to discover your purpose. Some of you are really afflicted by that. But we come against the spirit of the denial of truth. Yeah, we come against the spirit, a systematic account that is of a pseudo-based reality from the enemy. Yeah, that's trying to encumber your psychological state, Leo, at this time. But we come against that because the spirit says today that you're being, wisdom and conception is being unveiled into your spiritual womb. Yeah, please understand what I'm saying. This is much deeper than the surface. I'm not talking about an actualized womb. I'm talking about the womb of the spirit. Yeah, the womb that the divine can conceive your purpose into your life. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. wisdom that you would have not seen before. The veil of concave souls are being revealed. Yeah, souls that are chartering after the demise of your life. Yeah, what else behind the veil for Leo at this time, please? My goodness. Yeah, look at that. Persisting in yells of orchid splendor. Yeah, dying to live. My goodness. Yeah, dying to breathe new pathways of hope. Yeah, dying, yeah, to smell those orchid splendor. Yeah. A freshness is being, yeah, you're being renewed here. It doesn't seem like it, Leo. Yeah, but the divine is renewing you. You're being processed. Yeah, for greatness. Yeah, and Spirit is calling you to look to the intention of your energy. Yeah, check your intentions. Yeah, some of you are feeling very overly emotional right now. Or there's an influx. I shouldn't say overly, because there is no extent to your emotions and how you feel. Let me correct that. Yeah, a lot of you are just needing to refocus your energies. Yeah, so that you can you can bring your best self here to the table with the energies that you need to be focusing on. Because a lot of you, Leo, are focusing your energy on a lot of negativity. Don't do that. Yeah, because, yeah, there's no need to. Yeah, in the eyes of mourning. Yeah, some of you, when you rise, tears shed. I don't know who I'm talking to, Leo. When you rise in the morning, tears shed. Yeah, but those tears are not in vain. Yeah, in the eyes of mourning. What else for the embers, please, for Leo? What else for the embers? Thought I saw a card coming up. Yeah, what else spirits do we have for Leo at this time? Yeah, what did I say? What did I say, Leo? Yeah, no love, no me, nowhere. Yeah, there's a huge spirit of giving up here. Yeah, and I really hate to see this, Leo. Yeah, this is you not loving yourself. Yeah, feeling like there's no place for you here in this world. Nowhere left to turn. Hopelessness. Yeah, there's a spirit of hopelessness surrounding you, but we come against it in the spirit realm. Yeah, we come against the spirit of suicide. We come against the spirit of giving up. We come against it by the authority of the divine that is invested in my body while I'm speaking into this camera. And I don't care when you look at this, the spirit of the divine will impute themselves into you. Yeah, because we come against the spirit of not loving yourself. I don't know who I'm talking to. Yeah, no me, nowhere. Yeah, we come against that. Yeah, in the name of all that is divine. Yeah, a lot of you, hopelessness is all over this reading. Yeah, no love, no me, nowhere. No place for you, but there is. Your time is due to come, Leo. Yeah, your time is due to come. Don't listen to those demons. Yeah, those internal demons and battles you're fighting. Because Spirit says your time is coming. Yeah, your time is near. Mm-hmm. Spirit, what's happening in the spirit realm for Leo at this time, please? What's in the spirit realm for Leo? Give us further guidance here into what's going on concerning Leo at this time. What's happening in the spirit realm, please? Happening in the spirit realm for Leo. Yeah, we do see that Leo is facing great pain at this time, feeling hopelessness, the spirit of hopelessness, of self-doubt, yeah, self-refusal, not loving themselves. Yeah, feeling like there's no place for them left in the world and nowhere left to turn. No friends left. No family left, yeah. What's going on here? Happening in the spirit realm for Leo. Some of you are just silent muteness. Yeah. Happening in the spirit realm for Leo, please. Spirit realm for Leo. Give us divine truth, divine portals, access gained at this time. Yeah, what did I say? Look at that, Leo. Yeah, we have advocating self-refusal. Yeah, the denial of self showing up in the spirit realm. Living in self-denial. This card speaks directly to the rejection of self. Yeah, the ultimate betrayal of you. My goodness. Unable to locate your reflection in the mirror. Yeah, if you continue to reject yourself, Leo, my goodness, all of creation will follow. Yeah, Spirit is calling you to get out of this spirit of self-rejection and self-denial. Yeah, what did I say? Look at this, the reflection path of your subconscious revealing itself against abrogating self-refusal. This card speaks directly to you are in the processing of the mind's ego. What did I say? You're being processed by the spirit. Yeah, some of you, this may be the first time that this has happened in your life, I'm hearing. Above what's beneath the surface. Yeah, being able to finally look your soul in the reflection mirror. My goodness. Yeah, yet some of you are stopping running away from the needs and desires of your own soul. Yeah, you're extricating the mysteries afloat. Yeah, what you have been. Yeah, and there's a lot of pain surrounding this, Leo. Yeah, it was too painful for you to dig this deep. But you're finally finding the courage somehow to dig this deep within, which I do really love to see happening here in your energy space, Leo, that you're finding the courage and the strength. Yeah, I just saw the strength card in the spirit. Yeah, you showing up in your own reading, showing up in, for yourself this time. Yeah. Yeah, you're departing from the emptiness, my goodness, that once embraced you. My goodness, I love this, a spirit of emptiness. My goodness, hopelessness, I'm hearing a huge. Yeah, look at that. The spirit is calling you. Yeah, housing the loss that lives within. That's the issue. Yeah, the loss you want, you're not letting go of, Leo. Yeah, some of you have had a very dark. The number 1717 just popped up here on my clock. That's prophetic for some of you. Please look that up for prophetic meaning. 1717. But a lot of you, it's been too painful here. Yeah, you're still suffering from your past. A lot of you have had tragic lives here, dark past. Yeah, feeling like you there was never a window, an opening here of peace and understanding for you. But yes, it is. And this is because of the self-inflicted and self-induced pain that you're experiencing. And that's because you've been housing the loss that lives within. That's what happens to us, Leo, when we don't give up the pain. Yeah. And in your case, for a lot of you, because let me explain that too. There's a difference in giving the pain over to the divine, right? And then there's the whole dilemma of being depained once we give the pain back. Yeah, and the processing of being depained, Leo, is so that we can ultimately let the pain go. Because that's the issue, right? We can give the pain away and we can do the work to work on ourselves. In most cases, a lot of people do, right? Some people don't. You know, we're all different in the journey. But the fact of the matter is the collectiveness of what is ultimately all of our reality. Yeah. But you're choosing to love yourself this time. Spirit is calling you to love thyself first above all creations. Yeah, this is an issue of self-love. Yeah, self-respect. Yeah. Yeah, and that's because the soul has become the enemy. Yeah, look at that. Showing up here, domesticated carnivorous dog. Yeah, your own soul is the enemy. Yeah, the return to what the soul has already purged. Yeah, rise above what's been purged, Leo. Yeah, you've got to give it away. That's the problem. A lot of you aren't letting go of the pain. My goodness, who am I talking to? Leo. Yeah, we come against that spirit of replicated pain. Yeah, some of you are just, yeah, and it's like it's going in your mind over and over again about the past and how people have hurt you. Yeah, because your heart is so huge. My goodness, Leo, your heart is so huge and it's so full But guess what? The past is a teacher. Yeah. And the purpose of it, I don't know who needs to hear this. The purpose of pain is for us to repurpose the pain. Yeah, you repurpose the pain. And that's how you get to your promise. Yeah, and your divine future. Repurpose that pain. Utilize what's been purged, Leo. Utilize that pain. Maybe somebody needs to hear your story. I don't know. There's some of you out here. That's why I'm on here. Because the divine God has chosen you to use your story to help other people. And you're sitting there trying to wallow in this pity. But we come against the pity party. Yeah, we come against the self-inflicted and self-induced pain at this time. In the name of all that is divine, because God called you higher. Yeah, there's a higher purpose on you. Yeah, your heart was divinely orchestrated. Yeah, the very cells pumping in your blood were articulated by the words of the divine for a higher purpose. And we call that purpose into fruition at this time. I don't know who I'm talking to. Yeah, there's somebody on here that's chosen. Yeah, there's some of you, Leo, that have been chosen. Yeah, that's why you're in the wisdom and conception, the veil of the concave souls. Yeah, the premise of the veil. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and the spirit of the enemy is trying to make you feel like there's no love in your heart for yourself. My goodness. What's happening in the soul realm, please, for Leo? What's happening in the soul realm for my Leos, please? Happening for my Leos in the soul realm. Mm-hmm. Oh, I love to see this, Leo. Yeah, we have evocative sense of Malfi Jen presenting itself here in the soul realm. Evocative sense of Malfi Jen. This card speaks directly to the opening of the soul. My goodness, your soul is bursting open for the first time. Yeah, for a lot of you, Leo, this is the first time you've actually been able to feel. To be able to sit and feel yourself within yourself. Yeah, when you meet your soul, yeah, at the precipice of discovery. Yeah, and you sit there, yeah, whether you're alone or with people. Yeah, and you sit there and it feels like the walls are caving in. And you come to an ultimate realization of you. Yeah, and you look your soul in the mirror. Yeah, opening your soul to its senses and then becoming mute to the vanity of your own voice. My gosh. Yeah, your soul is in desperate need of validity. What did I say? Yeah, your soul is crying out to you. My God, look at this. But the caterpillar, my goodness, is showing up to fight on your behalf for a rebirth. Yeah, my goodness, this is some heavy. I'm telling you, I feel the spirit all over this. My goodness, a massive rebirth here is taking place for someone. Yeah, my goodness, tears of spiritual joy overflow me at this time. Yeah, because I feel you coming out of darkness. My goodness, I don't know. There's a lot of Leos. I don't know what you've been going through. But I'm telling you, you're coming out of this darkness. Because we have evocative sense of Mappy Jen and the caterpillar. My goodness. Yeah, the spirit is calling you inward. The spirit is calling you to wisdom and truth. And conception, new birthing out of your spiritual womb is taking place. The representative of the butterfly, which refuses to land, Leo. Yeah, you're being guided to seek truths from that which has been buried within the psyche. My God, you're being depained. What did I say, Leo? You're being depained. Yeah, the Lord is taking that pain out of your soul. Yeah, and filling it with the rebirth. Yeah, recite the heart once more and mourn what's been lost in the fire, Leo. And begin to start living fully and to depart from bondage. My goodness. My goodness, this reading. My gosh. Okay, let's move further into your reading, Leo. I want to use this deck here. What's happening for Leo? Let's dig deeper. We see here, yeah, that Leo has been suffering for quite some time, living in a spirit of darkness. Yeah, not loving themselves. Yeah, the refusal to love themselves. Yeah, loving everybody else, but not themselves. My goodness. Feeling like there's nowhere left to turn. Feeling all alone for quite some time. Yeah, feeling like they can only depend on themselves, but not even having them own selves to depend on. Who am I talking to? Because your soul has been dead. Yeah, this is a soul death. My God. We come against soul death in the name of all that is divine at this time. What's happening for Leo? Happening for Leo at this time, please. What's happening for Leo? Give us a dig deeper here. For Leo at this time, please. Happening. Leo, please. Give us divine truth. Play upon splitting of the deck. Yeah, what did I say? This is you all, Ten of Swords. Yeah, and those Ten Swords are the stabbing that you put in your own back. Yeah, spiritual death. What did I say? Soul death. This is not a spiritual death. Let me be very clear. Let me correct that. A soul death. Yeah, look at that. Yeah, look at that demon overseeing your downfall. My goodness. But look at this sprouting here. Look at your spirit. Yeah, and the divine giving you wisdom and conception into your heart. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we got Page of Cups in the reverse. Yeah, because you won't forgive yourself. My goodness, you have to forgive yourself, Leo. This is you not forgiving yourself. I don't know who I'm talking to. My goodness. Let's take a look deeper. What's going on with Leo at this time, please? Yeah, I see you becoming powerful. I just saw the Queen of Wands. Yeah, some of you are so powerful and don't realize your potential. Yeah, but you have it in you to become greatness. Yeah, you are greatness. You're literally greatness. You're literally a circle, a sphere of greatness, a walking miracle in motion taking place. And you don't see it. My goodness. Who am I talking to? First card we have. Yeah. Yeah, you're not looking. Yeah, you've been not looking within here, but you're getting ready to. Yeah, Page of Swords is the first card we have in the reverse. Yeah, you haven't been visible to your own self. Yeah, no passion, Ace of Wands. Yeah, look at this state of mind that you've been in here, Leo. Not attending to yourself, not caring about yourself. Page of Swords, not looking to the needs of your own self. Yeah, no passion here. Ace of Wands in the reverse. Mm-hmm. Yeah. No passion to create. No passion to move towards your destiny. Yeah, this feels like a very personal reading. Yeah, look at you just waiting here. Not knowing what to do. Three of Wands in the upright. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Three of Wands again. Look at that. Waiting. My gosh. Hopelessness. Yeah, Three of Wands twice confirms a spirit of hopelessness here. Yeah, look at that. Page of Pentacles again, or Page of Pentacles now in the reverse. Yeah, you're not forgiving yourself. That's very intense here. Very intense. What do we have for Leo? Yeah, not accepting the truth. Queen of Swords in the reverse. Yeah, concerning yourself. Yeah, look, you're in the Queen of Swords. But this is who you long to be. The Nine of Pentacles in the upright. But you have this within you, Leo. New doors opening. Yeah, and this is coming when you begin to love yourself. I don't know who I'm talking to. Yeah, and please don't misunderstand me, Leo. This is, and I know plenty of you have no issue with loving yourself, but someone needs to hear this. There are those of you, this is the message for those of you that are really going through a dark time. And there are some of you that are. And this message is for those people. My goodness. And this is amazing because what's happening is this growth that's finally taking place. Wisdom and conception. The premise of the veil. Yeah, this is the first solistic experience for some of you. Yeah, look at this. Your guard's up. Seven of Wands, fighting against yourself, fighting against other people because you're fighting against yourself. Yeah, walls, a barricade surrounding your heart. What next do we have for Leo, please? Leo, Leo, Leo. Okay, we have Knight of Pentacles in the upright. Yeah. And then you just keep going back and forth. But I see you ready to fight for yourself here. Yeah, you're for the first time, I see. Yeah, you look at that. You've been in hermit mode, Virgo energy, doing a lot of soul seeking. Yeah, and looking for ways to better understand your own self. You know, understand why you do. But, you know, a lot of us. Yeah, look at this. Nine of Pentacles in the reverse. That's you not loving yourself. Yeah, this is the card here. Nine of Pentacles in reverse. This is you not loving yourself. Feeling like you have nowhere left to turn. Nobody cares about me. Nobody loves me. That's not true, Leo. It's not. This is how you truly feel within your soul. I just saw the Hermit card again. It's not true. You do. People do love you and respect you. Yeah, Three of Cups. No celebrating. My goodness. You don't even celebrate yourself. My gosh. Yeah, look at this at the bottom of the deck. We have, look at that. Nine of Wands. This is you. Wounded warrior energy. Yeah, you just feel like the minute you open your eyes, you're walking into darkness. Look at that. Yeah, you just, it's an imbalance. Yeah, Six of Swords in the reverse. Yeah, refusing to move yourself forward. This is why you can't move forward. This is why you don't have any balance or peace. Because of you not loving yourself. You're wounded over the past. Yeah, you're wounded over your life. Broken over your life. My goodness. Page of Swords here. And the reverse for Leo. Yes, look at that justice coming in. This is the divine. Look at this. Libra energy, your first, yeah, coming up here to confirm for Page of Swords in the reverse. This is the divine giving you justice. Yeah, so that you don't have to miss any more opportunities. Some of you have a divine opportunity already in your fingertips. Yeah, that you're in right now. Yeah, that you're rejecting because of this pain. Yeah. And Spirit is calling you to not miss an opportunity or else you face karma. I don't know who I'm talking to. Yeah. And for a lot of you, this is a karmic debt. Yeah, of the divine. Yeah, some of you made a contractual agreement with the divine that you would go through these phases, right? That you would go through. Because a lot of people, you know, oh, well, God give me this and God give me, let me tell you something. We must travail. Yeah, it's through the travailing power and you traversing through these several dimensions of yourself. Yeah, and this is the sacrifice that we give to the divine for wisdom and truth. Yeah, and we do have karmic debts here when we're dealing with the divine. Yeah, and Spirit is calling you to not miss an opportunity on your own life. Yeah. Ace of Wands in the reverse. Yeah, I mean, look at you. Just no passion. Yeah, for living. I mean, some of you don't even do the things that you like to do. Or some of you don't even feel like, at this point, what do I like to do? You know, just like some of you are on a self-discovery, just discovering yourselves for the first time. You know, on a deeper level. Please understand what I'm meaning in the soul spheres. Yeah, slow movement. Yeah, you're just kind of sitting there. Knight of Pentacles and the upright. Yeah, the slowest moving knight in the entire tarot deck. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, see, you trying to, we have Two of Pentacles in the upright. You trying to make a decision here. Yeah, there's some decision you're all up in your head about. Yeah. Eight of Swords. Hmm. I do see here showing up in your reading now concerning your love life here. I see that there was an abrupt ending at some point or a separation from the Queen of Pentacles. That's Taurus energy. Could be dealing with the Taurus, your wish fulfillment. There was some type of an ending that caused a lot of grief in a connection. Five of Cups. Yeah, but the Divine is working on that as well. Yeah. Libra energy showing it up again. There was definitely some type of an argument here. Are you all probably not getting along? Yeah, and probably arguing. There's been arguing by the separation. Why is Three of Wands here? Which way be why you're waiting here and waiting? Three of Wands. Why is Three of Wands here? Yeah, you don't want to be left out in the cold. Yeah, that's what you're afraid of. Being left out in the cold. Or maybe, for a lot of you, what I do see that there was a separation before already. Because I'm seeing the World card in the reverse. So definitely a reconciliation. You're definitely wanting a reconciliation here. Definitely not wanting to walk away. Eight of Pentacles. I mean, excuse me, Eight of Cups in the upright. Yeah, so look at this. So you're working on yourself. Yeah, Knight of Wands. Or, excuse me, Knight of Swords in the reverse. Yeah, you're being, you know, more thoughtful about your words. Yeah, you're not being as combative. You know, I see that. That's been revealed to you. Yeah, and you, yeah, because you possibly could have caused this ending here. Yeah, Two of Swords and the reverse. Yeah, next to the Ten of Swords. Yeah, because of the conflict that was being caused over this pain that you're in, this brokenness. Yeah, so you're really monitoring your emotions right now, Leo. You're monitoring how your perception of self. Well, first of all, let me say this correctly. You're reviewing your own self-perception so that you can monitor others' perception of you. And not even their perception, their reality, right? What's actually taking place. Yeah. So that you can make improvements. Three of Wands, please. Two of Wands in the reverse. Yeah, so you definitely know which direction. Ooh. See? Yeah, this is really an internal fight here. This is because some of you are really in a lot of pain. Yeah, I see some of you are even having an issue here with just facing the truth about yourself. You know, this is really hard for a lot of you. We're holding yourselves accountable to these hard truths about yourself. Yeah, and it's really, this is really hard. I mean, because for a lot of you, and I'm just looking at the cards here and at spirit, because I just see so much entrapment and bondage. The bondage aspect of your reading is all over your reading, Leo, because here you're in Two of Wands in the reverse. So, you know, and you're just kind of basically going back and forth. Well, you know, do I have the courage to love myself? Am I capable of doing what I really know I can do? Because we have Two of Wands in the reverse, which speaks to not knowing which direction to take. But with that being in the reverse, you start to feel, you know, you go from waiting here, knowing what to do, and, you know, questioning, you know, really wanting to this reconciliation to work out and all that kind of stuff, and then knowing which direction to take. Okay, I'm going to do it this way this time. But then you just give up on yourself again. Ten of Swords in the upright. And then just grow cold, you know. Silent, mute within your own self. Hiding your emotions. Hiding how you truly feel. You know, not voicing how you truly feel. And then you go back into not knowing which direction to take anymore. You know, so it's just this back and forth. What did I say? The counter-dualistic soulism experience. The self and self experience. Spirit never lies. Yeah, that's, look at that. Yeah, and it's an internal conflict. Five of Wands in the upright. That's what it is, about loving yourself. Queen of Cups. Yeah, look at that. Not wanting to stand. It's feeling not, some of you feel too weak to stand in your own truth. Yeah. Queen of Swords in the reverse. Or too broken. I don't want to say weak. Because none of you are weak. You know, none of us are weak. It's about being, because you can be so heartbroken, Leo, that the pain is so great, it's just hard to see your way out. And that's what I think is happening for a lot of you. You know, it's just, sometimes it's too much. Our Queen of Swords in the reverse, please, for Leo. Yeah, Six of Cups now is showing up. This is gonna be soulmate connection, twin flame ex. Yeah, something you don't want to face. Yeah, that's what it is. And by you not facing these truths about yourself, it's causing you to not face the truth about what you've done in this connection here. Yeah, and this person loves you a lot. Yeah, Queen of Cups. Yeah, there was definitely an ending. Yeah, death card. Yeah, and that's what really is, you all are so upset. Yeah, Two of Cups in the reverse. Yeah, this is really painful because this is a true love connection here. Possibly the love of your life, I'm saying, for a lot of you. Because look at that. This person is the sun for you. And you're really, that's what's heartbreaking to you. Knowing that you had any part in the destruction of you all. Yeah, there was definitely a separation here. But I do see you wanting to come in and communicate and apologize about a Page of Swords. Yeah, trying to take back control. You know, of yourself and therefore control of the reconciliation that's taking place. The Emperor showing up to create balance, you know, between the two of you by letting these old demons go. You see that character back there? Because this is why your family, some of you lost a family. Lost your wife, lost your, you know, commitment. That person walked away because this was who you were showing up as. Yeah. That cold, dark energy. Yeah. Yeah, and you got to let them see them then very quickly. What did I say, Leo? You go back and forth from knowing what you need to do to putting back up your defenses. Yeah, because very quickly you move there again. Conflicting. Yeah, the confliction of self. Yeah, back to being on the defense. And this is because of this pain. Yeah, there's a... I'm hearing the spirit of fear of abandonment for some of you. I'm hearing the spirit of vulnerability, a fear of vulnerability, a fear of self-accountability. We just saw that come up in your reading from behind the veil. Yeah. And this is because you've been hurt so many times. Yeah, the serious pain from the past is all consuming you. Let's see. Seven of Wands. And it's hindering your future. Who am I talking to? Hindering your future. Yeah, these accumulated walls that you've built around yourself that you believe are protecting you, Leo, but they aren't. They're destroying you. You're destroying your own self. Yeah. Yeah, and this is why you all two aren't seeing eye to eye, Two of Swords. Mm-hmm. But you're coming in to communicate. Yeah, and look at this. My goodness. Page of Cups. Yeah, you're coming up because this is swallowing you whole with these emotions here, knowing what you could need to do to get you guys back on the same page. Yeah, and look at you stepping out of Nine of Wands energy. Wow. Yeah, some of you could have been, you know, just really flighty, you know, in and out of the connection. Mm-hmm. Yeah, afraid to commit. That's what it is. Some of you, yeah, look at that. The Fool card in the reverse, Aries energy, accompanied by the Hierophant. Yeah. And the reverse, which is Taurus energy, that speaks to commitment, marriage. Yeah, this is definitely, and there's this in it. And a lot of people probably aren't even aware of about this, Leo, because you're so passionate. And you could be very cold at the same time, right? Very blunt, very, and this is what I'm seeing in this reading. But making this person you're dealing with feel like you're not serious about the commitment as well. Juxtaposed to the fact that there's a fear of commitment. Yeah, I can see that it's very, very heavy. And which you know it's a fear because you have so much passion and desire and love for this person. Ace of Wands, full of passion. You have the Two Cups standing. Two of Cups, yeah. But so there's a fear on the inside of you. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Knight of Pentacles, please, for Leo. Yeah, yeah, but look at that. Temperance showing up now, Sagittarius energy. Yeah, you're going to go into creating balance. Yeah. To reverse, to stop this from, yeah, the discord between the two of you. Yeah, between you and your soulmate. Yeah, you're going to change that around, create balance between the two of you. Yeah, to reverse a tower moment, tower in the reverse. Yeah, I love to see this. Yeah, it's going to take you out of this grief. Yeah, this could be causing you a lot of grief as well. Yeah, I do see you get coming out of that. Yeah, being more, and this card also could speak to you being a little bit selfish or... here's the thing too, it could be perceived as selfish, but the thing of it is you really are taking some time to really heal yourself, Leo. That's what the thing of it is. It could be being perceived as that by your soulmate, but that's not true. I can see that in the reading. You love your soulmate. Yeah, you want to celebrate with them, but the problem is the refusal and denial of self, not being selfish. Yeah, there may have been that energy at some point, but that's definitely not the energy right now. It's about you trying to learn how to love on yourself. Yeah, and celebrate you. Yeah, and that's the conflict. That's the conflict that's coming in between you two. Yeah, that's the grief. Let's see, Nine of Pentacles in the reverse. Yeah, and look at that. That's the main energy, literally. Yeah, look at this King of Pentacles. Yeah, that's who you... Yeah, and that's what... Look at that. The devil in the reverse, though. Look at this. I love to see this. Yeah, that devil is being reversed. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that devil that's been stopping you, that has you in the King of Pentacles in reverse. Yeah, just put these two up right. Yeah, what's the devil doing? Destroying your connections, destroying your opportunities, destroying your finances. Yeah, this is who you're supposed to be, King of Pentacles. But, the devil, whatever it is, and some of you may have some addictions, you know, or whatever, toxic energy or whatever you developed over the pain, but you're letting it go. Yeah, this is being, the devil is being dismantled because you're in the processing of the divine. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it doesn't seem like it, but you are. Look at that. Yeah, for regarding this grief. Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is what's been keeping you. Yeah, why is the devil here in reverse, please? Devil in reverse. Yeah, look at that. The Emperor is your person. Yeah, and it's like they're literally... Yeah, a lot of you may be dealing with the Taurus here. This is Empress. Empress is embodies all of the queens of the entire tarot deck. The Empress is the only queen that does that, and that's Taurus. But they did with this person, and also for a lot of you, your crown chakra is being accessed at this time, which is why you're gaining this wisdom and conception is being opened. But this person is the one for you. This person is your soulmate. This person is loyal, hardworking, loving. The Empress is everything all in one. And this person is literally sitting here watching you just die on the inside. Spirit just said that to me. They're just watching you. Look at this. How does she, he or she, they're just sitting there watching you and all this turmoil and this soul death. Look at that, Leo. They're just watching you. They're there to support you. They want to celebrate with you. They love you. Yeah. But you're closing yourself off. You're closed off. Look at that. Four of Pentacles. Yeah. You don't. Yeah. Three of Cups in the reverse, please, for Leo. Oof. Oh, my goodness. Look at this. Look at you coming out of protecting yourself like that. Four of Pentacles in the reverse now. Yeah, Eight of Cups. Yeah, look at you coming back to yourself. This is you walking back into yourself. Yeah, and walking. My God. What did I just say? Nine of Pentacles. Look at you taking your power back. My goodness. Nine of Pentacles in the upright, Leo. Oh, man. Oh, man. Yeah, Three of Pentacles. Let's see here. Yeah, Three of Pentacles in the reverse. Yeah, because you're done with this old version of you. Yeah, you're done lying to yourself, telling you you're not good enough. Tired of listening to the lies of the enemy. Seven of Swords in the reverse. You're not listening to it anymore. You're tired of betraying yourself, hurting yourself, blaming yourself for everything in the past. You're tired of that, Leo. Yeah, that's why you're in hermit mode, Virgo energy. Doing the soul work necessary, yeah, to stand in your truth. Yeah, look at that. Nine of Swords. Yeah, coming in fast. Yeah, doing a self-review. What did I say? Self-actualized accountability at play here. Deciding to love yourself. Two of Pentacles at the bottom of the deck in the upright. Why is Nine of Swords here? Yeah, and this is your main energy. You're not loving yourself here. You being wounded is what's been causing this imbalance, not only in yourself, but in your relationship here, your soulmate connection. Some of you definitely may be married here. Nine of Wands. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but look at you stepping into happier times. Three of Cups in the upright. Being able to celebrate. Yeah, conflict being removed out of your life. Yeah, look at that. Five of Pentacles in the reverse. Yeah, you're not going to leave yourself. Yeah, the desires of your soul, the needs of your soul, in the cold anymore. Yeah, and by you doing that, no one's going to be leaving you in the cold. Yeah, because you're tired of things not turning in your favor. Wheel of Fortune in the reverse. Yeah, tired of not getting the desires of your heart, the store card in the reverse. Yeah, you're tired of that. That's what it is. You're tired of not harnessing your intuition, giving yourself what you need on the inside. Yeah. Tired of living on the bread of external alone. Yeah, you're tired of heartbreak. Yeah, Three of Swords in the reverse. Mm-hmm. Yeah, look at that. Six of Swords in the reverse, please. Yeah, the heartbreak is over. Yeah, not being able to access your intuition is over. Yeah, not receiving wish fulfillment's over. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, what did I say? Yeah, there was an argument. And there's been, like I said, conflict on the internal. But the two of you definitely could have had an argument. And then which is why you cut yourself off. But guess what? You're taking the journey here. Because you don't want to, you're not going to do this anymore. This Ten of Swords. That's not the story. Yeah, the reversal of your soulmate connection. You're not going to do that based on this old pain from the past. Mm-mm. You're not doing that. You're not doing it. You're not doing it, Leo. You're tired of it. Yeah, you're wanting to move into calmer water. Yeah, and some of you have been definitely in a lot of pain because of knowing the fact that you're hurt and broken. And that's what's causing things to not, balance to not come in between you and your soulmate. I see that heavily too. But don't worry, Leo. Things will be fine. Things will be fine. Let's see. Let's get energy for Leo. What energies does Leo need to focus on this time, spirit? Energies for Leo at this time, please. Energies for Leo, okay. Look, oh my goodness, say yes. My goodness, stop saying no to yourself and no to people. Quit pushing yourself away. And by you pushing yourself away, you're pushing everybody else away, Leo. Stop pushing everybody away. Because you're pushing yourself away. And realize that, what did I say earlier? That you're a living, breathing, walking miracle in motion. Look at that. Yeah. My, oh gosh. You are entering a time of happiness. My goodness, I love to see this for Leo. My goodness, entering a time of happiness. And Spirit is calling you to be your own guide. Yeah. Focus on the needs of your soul. Yeah, my God, what did I say? That a lot of you are chosen. The universe has a plan for me. Look at that. My gosh. Oh, angels are all around you, energizing your soul. You're divinely protected at this time. Leo, the angels of protection are protecting your soul. Look at that. Yeah, you're done comparing yourself. Yeah, become the incomparable you. Yeah, that's what the spirit is saying here. And you're opening your heart to loving yourself, Leo. Opening your heart to loving yourself and therefore being receptive of the love that the people who do love you are trying to give you. My goodness. Wow, this is amazing. This is amazing. This is amazing, Leo. I really enjoyed this reading for you all today. My goodness. Well, that's all I have for you all, Leo. But before I let you go, I do manifest at this time that you would be, that at this time, you would no longer continue to deny your own self. That you would, we draw up the spirit of self-refusal, self-denial, and every self-refutation. Yeah, I come against the spirit of suicide. I come against the spirit of hopelessness at this time and emptiness of the soul. And soul death. Yeah, I manifest that Leo will begin loving themselves fully and wholly. No longer feeling like there is nowhere for them. No place for them. No room for them. Yeah, for their light to shine. Because your light is shining from a womb of conception of the spirit. That you have not stepped into until this day. Yeah, but the faces of the deep speak your name. Yeah, the stars align on the behalf of the premise of your veil. Yeah, I see it in the spirit. Yeah, we come against Leo feeling like they have nowhere left to turn. Yeah, we take those tears that Leo sheds in the morning when they rise due to the pain that they have not let go of. We give those tears over into the divine for the repurposing of your pain. Yeah, I speak from an authority of heavenly places. Yeah, divinely invested in me to manifest this in your life at this time. Yeah, we come against the spirit of the enemy. Yeah, and we harness self-actualized accountability at this time. Yeah, that Leo would no longer be the enemy of the soul. We come against that in the spirit realm at this time. I manifest that you would be, that you would welcome the resurgence of the pain, not to stay in the pain, but so that you can be depained. Yes, yes, who am I talking to? Depained, yeah, so that what has already been purged, you would not become the domesticated carnivorous dog and return to your own vomit, because we come against the spirit of vomit at this time, yeah, the demon of vomit. We come against it at this time in the name of all that is divine, that's trying to get Leo to revert to what has been purged. Yeah, to revert to the pain that's been given away. But we come against it by the depending of that pain for the repurposing of that pain in your life at this time. Yeah, and I speak all of these things and manifest them into your life by the name of all that is divine, Leo. I leave you all with that. I love you all so much. I'm really, really rooting that the best takes place in your life on your magnificent journey. Yeah, that you would begin loving yourself wholeheartedly. Yeah, doing the work necessary that's required of you for the betterment of your life. And we see that you're walking into happiness now. Your journey begins as it's never began before. And I leave you all with that. I love you all so much. Namaste. And until the next reading, please be blessed. And I'll see you on the next reading. Take care.